The views and comments expressed on the following radio program by its hosts and their guests do not necessarily reflect the views of RMCOnAir.com or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
Radiation contaminating across every nation, levels manipulated. Man, they steady raising devils, worship Satan. Hell bent on the population infiltrating West Coast. Let's go. Time to blaze new routes, occupy land. Harp induced food droughts, causing famine. Forbidden fruits, mercury and salmon. He who controls the food, controls the masses. Fascists wanna smash us up in FEMA camps and feed us rations. RFID, what could it be on top of your bones? You need the terrorists, they dropping bombs through drones right on top of your home. NDAA, you gone. It's a red alert, a 911 emergency. We do this for the planet. Forget the currency, a red alert, a 911 emergency. We need him. Seize the change of world's frequency, a red alert, a 911 emergency. We do this for the globe. Forget the currency, a red alert, a 911 emergency. Does your head hurt? Your flesh burns 30 degrees.
Wake up, time to raise your conscience. Government trying to fill your brain with nonsense. Don't believe everything you read and use TV just to plant the seed. What they want you to buy, want you to try. Make sure you cry when they want you to cry. They quick to televise bombs in Boston, but they won't tell you about how Keisha died an orphan. Church raised funds to provide an offering. Still wasn't enough to buy your coffin. Gang violence, it makes the news. So you look at minorities with hateful views, not knowing that your kids.
Welcome everybody to where we're just going to get it in for No On, Prop 64, No On, AUMA.
Just going to go on right to it? Got to go ahead and be a savage, man. You got to let them know.
All right, so I got some notes this time so I can keep it together. So first I want to introduce our featured guest. Tonight we're going to talk about a couple different segments.
What's up, you guys? I'm E-Zone, in case you guys don't know. Some of you guys might see me on B-Real TV. That is the home base where I'm, like, usually dwelling at. But, you know, my boy Jimmy over here, he's been doing it for a while. He's been going out to these events. And although he's, like, one of the quietest dudes I know, he's making a big impact with, you know, with the whole getting signatures and, you know, getting everybody informed properly. So when he reached out to me about coming out here, I was like, yeah, man, you're the first person who actually convinced me to actually go out there and actually sign a paper to make a change. I was like, oh shit, I'm gonna vote.
You know, that's the king, the key. There's a lot of different
participation
scenarios where you got the equivalent to the fat person in the gym telling you how to do something. So one of the things I keep throwing myself in a different position of is how a lot of these things function in different stages. So if I can get to a part where I get someone to tell someone else something I told them and they accepted it and understood it, if the cop was telling you something opposite right next to me, then we're in a good spot for where your thinking's at. So we got Miss Natural Red over here.
What's up? What's up?
We got a Stone Still crew in the house.
What's up? How's everybody?
Right. And we got some friends in the on the side over here. Bernard, Hugo, JB. I can't remember your name, sir, over there. All right. Okay, so the main couple of segments we're going to try to address. The first half of the show, we're going to go into the money behind this thing. Because you got one of the things I try to think about is I have to present a story to you with this, with these 20 episodes that we're trying to bang out. And the first part was to introduce you to the show. So now the next part is I got to tell you the story of why we're going to get to this No On AUMA. I'm not going to give you some stupid meme and tell you because I said so, you're stupid if you don't agree with me. I'm showing up to all these spots. I'm making them deal with me. You know, I'll lay in the cut at the you know, the people that are for it. I'll stay in the cut on the back. And they ask me some questions, I'm going to stick my hand up. If they call on me, they're going to get the answer. This shit got so serious we had to make a show over it. Because won't nobody read this thing? It's not that hard. It's just you just have to understand.
So. I would say it's hard for people, it's hard to convince a group of stoners, okay? Like, it's like, I don't know, like, I'm pretty sure everybody here has been to events, you notice that it's very hard to keep, like, especially our community focused on certain things. Like, we've all seen the example with music. It didn't work with Lil Wayne, although motherfucker smokes a lot, it didn't matter. You know what I'm saying? Our crowd didn't react to it. Same thing here, like, we need individuals to point out, it's like, look, if you're a regular smoker and you dab every day, or a patient, whether you're a regular smoker just because recreational or you're a patient, these 3 points right here is what's going to be taken out of your lifestyle if you vote for this, or if this passes or this doesn't. Because, like, to be honest, when somebody like hands me like a paper and says, hey, can you sign this, like, I'm gonna look at it, I was like, dude, you just want my information. Like, I mean, I'm not saying that's like, you know, that's what everybody thinks I'm talking about myself, but you know what I'm saying? It's like, as like a medical marijuana patient, you know what I mean?
Hard hurdle to overcome.
It is, man. It's like, it's almost like you're signing this. It honestly looks like a car dealership application. Like, you know, when they hand it to you.
can you tell us just real quickly the first complaint I ever had when I met you, because you were trying to teach me how to get people to sign these things, and you were telling me, tell me how you were telling people
you to tell them what to do.
Okay, yeah.
Essentially, you straight on,
like,
walk
I was
up
like,
and
fuck
say,
fuck that. I'm going to sit down with them for like 15 minutes, 30 minutes, and tell them the whole thing as much as I can, like in one shot. Whoever takes it, maybe they'll tell someone.
Three
else.
Lines hit it.
Now I'm at, you have to fucking sign it, you know? I'm at where he's at. This guy knows how to get the signatures. I didn't take his advice right away because I was trying to, you know, help you understand.
It's funny you mention it that way, man, because, like, in the beginning when I first met this guy, you know, he tried to, like, sit there and explain it to me. And, like, when I'm walking around these events, like, I'll have, like, 4 different kind of people trying to get my attention. So, like, I'm over here. I was like, I'm just trying to go ahead and give everybody, like, yeah, you know, I got you. So, like, as, like, I kept seeing him more events, he, like, at the end, he was just like, yeah, this is why I signed this one. You didn't sign this one. I was like, okay, cool. I know it's going for a good change. Like, but, like, yeah, like, nowadays, like, you just point out the bulletins. You're like, hey, you like coming to these events? Like, for example, you like coming to these medical marijuana patient events? Guess what? If this thing passes, it's not going to be available no more. You say that to somebody that's, like, going to an event, and they're going out there, and this is the only chance they're going to get a $35 eighth or a $20 gram of shatter to smoke or something.
Just to smoke.
And they take that away from them,
like normal, not sneak around in the alley or in your room and be afraid of who's watching.
McDonald's parking lot and shit, you know?
Like, straight up, like, I came from the East Coast, and back East, it was like you had to go to someone's house, you had to go to some basement, you had to be in someone's backyard,
give some money to a stranger.
When I came out here and I actually got to sit with a bunch of people in a normal place and just spark up and just have like
a circle,
and it not have a stigma attached to it, that's a mind blowing experience. And a lot of people in this country don't get to experience that. Yeah. They smoke weed, and it's always like a kind of deal. And that's the part of this education that we need to push out, because all of these laws are going to affect the way people are going to consume.
Absolutely.
Where they can consume, how they can consume, what versions, how much they're going to pay, how much they're going to be involved in it.
Let me go into – let me give out the call-in number, 323-965-1600. Anybody has any questions or stuff they want to talk about with the show? Let's see. We need some sponsors to keep the show going, too. So check out the PayPal in the Hemp Hop Show's bio.
Jimmy, why don't you tell them one of the main things that's gonna that affects, like, us, like, as a community here? Because, like, we've all in the same room. We've been in, like, many situations where we're all consuming cannabis. And I mean, what's one of the main things that they're gonna take away that we all, like, here in this room could, like, really care about? I mean, I mentioned one of the things, like, they're gonna take away the possibilities of having, quote unquote, you know, these little sessions or they're gonna take away this opportunity to do this. Although they give you the quote unquote line saying that, oh yeah, you know what, but once this passes, like, you're gonna be able to change it after it passes. It's like, no, it doesn't need to go there. It doesn't need to go there. We need to get it straight the first time. Like, what else is one of the things are going to take away from us if this passes, bro?
One of the first things, okay, look, people say, oh, it works in Colorado or whatever. I haven't been to Colorado, but I keep seeing the pictures where they're busting people for the open public consumption.
Yep.
There's a section in here that says you can't give stuff away, you know?
So, like,
you got to write that in there if this is about legalization and you got some other thing that says you can do.
So no more free meds.
It says no promotional stuff.
So, like, for example, like, to let the stoners out there listening. So, like, if you're going to, like, let's just say a chalice or a secret session or any little event that's going on, right? And you have a company that's specifically made all this meds, like, eighths or grams of shatter that they give out to the individuals that really show up, that may not have the luxury of a connoisseur to buy the top shelf grams. And this is really all they're kind of hoping for. They're really kind of taking this away. So this is not going to be no longer available. A company that, like, for example, like the doctor's Oracle, let's say I wanted to give away 100 grams of something. I can't do that no more if Alma were to pass? No? Damn, that's unfortunate, man. See, you stoners that are listening, or you medical marijuana patients, these are the things that you fail to see when you don't read between the lines here. You need motherfuckers that are in tune and that'll go ahead and read it out. Be like, yo, you like coming to this shit? You like going ahead and getting some of the free samples and sample some of the best?
We know they do.
Yep, you know they do, because I see the lines.
We do. Exactly.
Some of you guys go crazy in these lines over here, man. I've seen it. I've hosted events where I've given out samples and motherfuckers is fighting. It's the reality of it, you know. And
I think the big takeaway everyone in the audience needs to know is there are a lot of special interests that are jockeying for position right now to take advantage of what a lot of people out there have been fighting tooth and nail, have gone to jail, have had their lives negatively impacted, and then now the at records. The moment when it's about to come out and be free and clear, all the people that fought, they're going to end up being denied the advantages and the benefits of that struggle.
Battle.
You know what I'm saying? And then the corporations are going to take in, and everything's going to get bought out and parceled out. And then by the time it all settles out, everyone's going to be like, remember the good old days?
Exactly.
Back in the early 2000s. What happened to those days? Why? Yeah, I know weed is legal, and you can go down to 7-Eleven and buy your weed.
We used to have social gatherings. Now we can't even do that.
Yeah.
You know, because Prop 215 and AUMA cannot coexist together.
They cannot.
They're trying to Walmart the game, pretty much, man. That's what it's coming
together,
down to.
So, you know,
they want to give you a GMO strain.
And I mean, listen, I empathize with all with that aspect of it, but listen, the other part of it, true
citation. Yeah, you know, I want to point this out. The way they word this to us, like, you can't like give a bunch of this right here. Like what I just said to you guys earlier, it says, oh, you can't give away promotional items, like no more free grams. Yeah. This is the way they word it. No license shall give any amount of marijuana or marijuana products or any marijuana accessories as a part of a business promotion or any other commercial activity.
So you can't even get a goodie bag.
I mean,
no free samples.
Yeah, no free samples. I mean, you give this to like somebody who's like consuming cannabis every day, you need to word it differently or find a person to deliver it differently, because they purposely do this. So we look past it and say, oh, it's political stuff, we don't want to get involved. Because a lot of us in the community really don't look to get involved. It really don't. Like, I mean, it's unfortunate, but like,
it really is.
Yeah.
Because it's in your best interest.
Yeah, like, it's almost like you need somebody not necessarily to, like, dumb it down a bit, but just to, like, hey, you know what? Like you said, tell you what to do. Like, hey, this is what's getting taken away. You like this? Cool, boom, sign this. Here it is.
You know, the numbers count.
A, B, C, D.
Numbers
3, 4.
This is what the full 64-page...
64-page.
Out copy.
What do we say when it's 64?
Yeah, they hide the beat in the middle.
So this is what you were saying before about, you know, we're not trying to dumb it down for you, but this is what they're asking you to pick through and understand and read.
Right.
And that's very difficult. I went through with a red pencil and marked all of my questions.
Yeah.
But not everybody has the time to do that, so it's wonderful that we have someone like Jimmy here who's going to sit down and say, let me give you some of the highlights. Let me tell you how this is going to impact you.
Exactly.
And it's great to see everybody in the room here tonight, because this is important, you know.
It really is. And the way that they're just promoting it by saying, you know, the adult use of marijuana, like making it seem like, oh, they're really doing something for the people. This has nothing to do with the people. The current system we have isn't broke, so why do they need to fix it?
Well, I don't know if I agree with that. I think the current system does need a lot of fixing. I've been in and out of this. I've been in and out of this battery business for a long time.
215 is much better than AUMA.
I'm with her on that, because I think at the end of the day, when they do label it the Adult Use of Marijuana Act, they're trying to say at the same time they're tweaking that and saying we're all adults.
What's the very percentage of the whole thing?
Exactly.
It's also a subtle implication that
it starts out non-medical marijuana.
It's about children.
Yeah. Unregulated. That's because it doesn't exist.
You know, the real put two Prop 15 together, right?
But where it is now, it's like the OGs put that. Once they make it recreational.
One of the big problems I've seen, because like I said, I came from the East Coast.
Right.
And I came out here 6 years ago, and you know, when I came out here, I didn't know anything about dispensaries, medical marijuana, and all that. Man,
seemed unreal.
Back east, you just went, found somebody who was willing.
Look how I say, right. You got some more?
And, you know, I've worked in dispensaries. I've worked in different cannabis businesses over the years.
Okay, so who do you think is the money behind this thing?
Well, it's obvious it's special interests.
Let's talk about who specifically is the money behind this thing.
If I'm going to take a guess, I'm going to say tobacco company, Big Tobacco.
Philip Morris.
And here's the thing. There's a whole problem going on in the medical marijuana industry, because truth be told, it's still a gray area. legally speaking, right. there's still a lot of restrictions.
Oh, no, we got over that the top real of clear. That. I got 62 pages so of you, yes. black right. and white. There's no more gray.
And I'm just talking about outside of that. I'm just talking about
hetero versus
not one part of this is gray. Yeah. Right. Black,
so you're talking
red.
About people like, even under the 215.
Okay, so I need to stick to what this is going to. So,
okay. We went off.
We want to get to his own song.
Yes.
We don't smoke the same.
That's actually, my music, for those of you guys who don't know, I do music, I make it more relatable for, like, the individuals in our community. So, like, I'm talking about either consuming cannabis or, like, sometimes I don't really try to get too political on it, but, like, yeah, like, I am an individual artist, and at the same time, like, I have a group called We Don't Smoke the Same with my boy from Be Real TV. It's Sheiky and myself, so, like, we are a group, and some of you guys might have seen us perform in the music. Which one are you gonna play for him?
This one. The one you put in the
Oh, that's you know what? Oh, the one with the little political reference in the beginning. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know what? This is the self-titled one. We don't have a video for you, but you can listen to the track. It's called We Don't Smoke the Same, and it's like I literally say it in the beginning. It's like I'm tired of being called the suspect for the top shit that I smoke. Yeah. And it's like yeah. So like I mean I don't know. Hopefully you guys appreciate it and you guys check it out. Get the message in it. You know.
Sure.
Yep.
System edition.
What's this now?
We don't smoke the same.
Nope.
You basically put you to shame.
What?
With a tip in my joints that we smoking for real. We straight to the point, blowing smoke to your face. We don't smoke the same.
Nope.
You basically put you to shame.
What?
With a tip in my joints that we smoking for real. Fuck the police, blowing smoke to their face.
I'm tired of being called a suspect.
Fuck the police.
Cause that top shit that I smoke. Said we try and live free, but we get no respect.
Nope.
So I'd rather die faded than to die.
I guess the technical difficulty there.
Sometimes it get technical like that, man. You know, it happens.
It was going too hard.
Can you explain to us the what got you to the part where you had to make that? Because I don't remember the whole song, but I remember
like the
there's a part that's like fuck the police, we don't give a fuck. So this all.
Well, it's pretty. I guess it's a combination of the experiences that I had like growing up. It's like and I mean I even had bad experiences with the police and weed out here. And we're fortunate like in. Pretty like very well like spoiled out here in California with our lifestyle with the cannabis. So like I guess an accumulation of like being in trouble with like you know like getting pulled over and like a fucking roach will get the car searched and there's nothing to hide. You know what I mean? Or like
and so what they do when they sit you on the ground? They say, I'm just doing my job.
Yeah, they just yeah. I don't that it's a combination of all that and also the Pop Brothers of Law. Like you know they were talking to me like hey man you know like I like you like talking about consuming cannabis like. Give a little message, motherfuckers is listening to you, and I put it out there, and like surprisingly, like that part in specific, a lot of motherfuckers feel it, cause there's a lot of people that like, you know, if you grew up in like a what is it like urban area, you know what I'm saying, quote unquote the hood, you know, like it's you're getting harassed all the fucking time for this shit, you know what I mean? That's just like an indication, just like it's a little like door, like they put their foot in the doorstep to get a little insight to your life, to see if they get you for something bigger. So like it was in the combination of all that stuff that just kind of made me write that. Part and especially that fuck the police blowing smoke to their face, and I kind of said that part because like I guess in a sense I've been fortunate enough to kind of be in that situation where like I've seen a cop in like maybe in San Bernardino fairgrounds and they're walking around and I'm just like yeah like I'm just like I hope you catch that whip right here.
It's America. It's supposed to
get I give that extra power walk to get a couple feet in front of him and be like he's gonna get this cloud.
And don't be fooled for a second. Every cop out there still wants weed to be illegal.
Oh yeah.
And if they could find an excuse to make it illegal again, they will hop right.
That's
back
one less check for them, bro.
That's why somebody will tell me over and over again, like, oh, it doesn't do this, it doesn't touch this. Okay, watch this. The police aren't supposed to be killing us, but they are.
Yep.
Okay. Now
right.
I see this as additional 60 pages of if I hand this to a cop.
and he's gonna be like, oh, I get to do all this to them? That's 60 pages. I'm just doing my job to you.
That's the reality right there.
I'm gonna do my job to you on this page, all these.
Oh, I can't get you for this one? Well, hold on, let me turn the page. I got another one right here.
Yeah.
Oh, you passed this one? Hold on, Lick. I got another one right here. Like, the list will go on until you get in some cups. Yeah. It's just one of those things that they're really trying to, like, make it like alcohol, and it's not. You have to treat it differently. You have to pave its own way for this thing. It's not like you can't treat it like alcohol. You know what I mean? You like, there's no way. It's not the same thing.
It's simply a medicine.
Yeah.
It's
simply a medicine. We do not tax any more for medicines or medical areas coming from these big pharmaceutical companies. Yep. However, they want to turn around and extort the money out of the medical cannabis patients in the state of California through taxation.
Yeah,
I mean, that's
double
just
taxation.
Exactly, it's double.
They're
going to tax it on the farmer. They're going to tax it on the patient. At the same time, they're going to tax it on the people who provide that to both.
Yep. Yeah.
For someone like me, the I growers, have epilepsy. Exactly. I have pharmaceutical medication as a backup. I use CBDs as my main source. That means my things that are not taxed because they come from a pharmacist are now 75% of my medication is suddenly going to be massively taxed, and that impacts my epilepsy. That impacts whether I'm going
to
have a seizure.
You're not going to be able to treat it sometimes, you know?
Exactly. And then, you know, there's going to be people who are going to be put into even worse situations.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's really, it's really unfortunate. They're really taking a lot of rights from, like you said, like the people that have really fought here a lot, you know, like for
activists. About companies that take certain stance.
Like, you know, are you talking about like big corporate companies that are trying to come into our industry?
Well,
or then that don't really know too much about cannabis, or what are you talking about?
That I got, I'm less than pleased with Weed Maps.
Okay.
With this agenda, but I can also tell you, I'll technically, personally give Normal a pass because they told us we're just going to go for anything that sticks and makes it to the ballot. So they told us that ahead of time, but Weed Maps gave them a fat chunk of money. And so that had me delete that app real quick.
Like I said, man, that I feel like that's like a big, quote unquote, what is it? It's like a big Walton step. If you don't know what I mean by that, it's like those are the people behind Walmart.
Right.
You know, like, yeah, those are the people that own Walmart. And like, if you don't know about the Walmart effect, they take your local business, run them out of town, and have this big corporate fucking company that's coming in here and just taking over thing. It's like, I feel like they're trying to do the same thing to our industry. So they just have like another, like a big company, like let's say Weed Maps. It's like they partnered up with everybody who actually has the money to do it. And they're going to set up this big, beautiful looking theme park thing.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like for all the people.
Okay. So part of the segment was about the money behind this. So from my experience, I'm going to tell you, for CCHI to get on the map, we need at least $4 million. And let me tell you how that number plays out. AUMA is on the ballot because it forced its way in with money, okay? These signatures were $2 each that they paid for, okay? All somebody had to do was walk up to you and say, hey, you like weed? Sign it. Just like he says. Sign
it. That's how they were getting people at the post office.
All day long. Okay, watch this. Okay, we needed 300,000 signatures, 365, whatever it is. They need to bring like 600,000 signatures to have some valid ones. For the next go-around, it's supposed to be somewhere around double that. The number is like around 750,000 signatures you need to get something in, which means you got to bring 1 million signatures. So if they forced it in at $2 each, I can tell you the top one we had on the stack was $5 a signature, okay? So you need at least $3 million to get 1 million signatures at $3 each. Then we need $1 million like they just dumped into AUMA for advertising to go send people around and be like, hey.
Get it out there. Get a couple celebrities and kids' babies.
Time, let's put a one-page CCHI on the ballot. With $4 million. Okay, so we're gonna go to, you ready we're gonna go to a Smokeville break, play a couple flyers for you, and then we'll come back with Red.
Yeah.
And we're gonna get into whatever she got some stuff to say.
Yeah, I got some real serious stuff for people that's hitting in the pages that you'll be like, what? Yeah. And that's the way that they do. That's how those bills work. That's why they make them so large.
Hidden agenda.
Yeah, it's always a hidden agenda. It's always more than
some good stuff in
what they're trying to say, hidden in between the lines in the pages. The average person, like you said, isn't going to read all that. We're just going to say, oh, we can smoke weed legally? I'll sign. But it's more behind it, and that's what we need to know.
Smoke break.
They want you to smoke weed on a leash.
All right, so we're going to go to, we'll come back, call in 323-965-1600. Go to the Instagram bio. Come on, man, help the show exist. It don't cost that much. Just throw a little drop
people
in the bucket.
Do your part. Yeah.
Thank you, please.
Right? Yeah, man. Thank you, guys.
I don't want to sell you nothing. I want to give it to you.
Bang. but it knows when I'm sipping up a cry. Plenty drugs, it's a pot. But I'm in the Mary Jane and I think I hear her calling. Kush, Kush, call it, Kush, Kush, call it, Kush, Kush, call it, Kush, Kush, call it, turn to the max, no Molly. She playing with her nose when I'm sipping on my car. Plenty drugs, it's a party. But I'm in the Mary Jane and I think I hear her calling. Kush, Kush, call it, Kush, Kush, call it, Kush, Kush, call it, Kush, Kush, call it. Voice of the hippies, got dope for the stoners, dick for the bitches, middle finger for the rollers. I'm good in the hood, on the block, on the corner. Only smoke the pack if the bag got an odor. OG Kush, you can smell the aroma. Smoke the veal here, you can smell the aroma. I'm Cali grown, real nigga, no flex on. You talk tough, any words for your headstone. 91 West, send them straight to your city. West Coast connected and pussy get plenty. Respected by OGs, real niggas fuck with me. If you niggas smoke, then you best to come get me. Turn to the max, no mob. She playing with her nose when I'm sipping up a car. Plenty drugs, it's a pot. But I'm in the Mary Jane and I think I hear her calling. Kush, Kush, call it, Kush, Kush, call it, Kush, Kush, call it, Kush, Kush, call it. Never go soft for the sucker shit. If your beam's in my DM, then later she'll be sucking dick, sucking dick. I teach her how to drive a stick, break the weed down, roll a blunt, how to ride a dick. My lingo's jalapeno, got a heat flow. Your ego is not your amigo. I'm hella saucy, on point like Stacey Adams. No love for these hoes, bro, you gotta pass them. I stay away from the fakes. Keep my weed close, watch out for the jakes. My life is like a movie and I'm living half-baked. I'm California homegrown, my home state. Nigga, join my program, my campaign. Menace to society, nigga, and I'm Kane, huh? I cause ruckus for the pussy lame suckers. Always been a G, down, down for the ruckus. To the max, no Molly. She playing with her nose when I'm sipping up a car. Plenty drugs, it's a party. But I'm in the Mary Jane and I think I hear her calling. Kush, Kush, call it, Kush, Kush, call it, Kush, Kush, call it, Kush, Kush, call it. Turn to the max, no Molly. She playing with her nose when I'm sipping up a car. Plenty drugs, it's a party. But I'm in the Mary Jane and I think I hear her calling. Kush calling, call it. Kush, Kush calling, call it. Kush, Kush calling, call it. Kush, Kush calling, call it. Bang.
On that bomb player, them California trees, them real sticky, icky, hydroponic, chronic leaves. It's only grown in water, it's what the doctor ordered, and I ain't even gotta get it from across the border. I'm smoking legal, I'm at the weed store, I go pick what I want, bag it up, pay and roll. Sativa for the day, indica for the night, 24/7 keep my body feeling right. I roll it up in my zero double XL, don't want no other taste, don't want no other smell. And my license say that I can smoke all day. And if I got a little plot, I can cultivate and keep a half a pound in my crib at all times. With an ounce off in my purse, so yeah, I'm doing fine. Moving back to Oklahoma, last thing on my mind. I'm on the east side of Long Beach. Time you wake and bake, boy, I done woke and smoke. Brush my teeth, cook some breakfast, and then choke some more. You bout four blunts behind, I got the fifth in line. Your lungs can't hang with mine, fool, I can smoke you wine. I don't think no girl can smoke as many blunts as me, except my girl from OKC, Sally Tammy T. We posted up on Florence, got seven blunts roll. It's only four people, oh yeah, we bout to blow. Abusive, Diamond and Skywalker, OG. Liquid, butter, private reserve, Louis 13. We
top shelf, cheap until somebody tap out. You say you always smoke, we gon' see what you about. It ain't no eye closing, it ain't no power napping. Inhale this chronic smoke, choke it out and let it happen. And put your hand up in the sky if you need some air. You said you wanted to get high, so we gon' take you there. I'm high in the Cali palm off that Cali bomb. 420, that's my set, now let me court you on. So you can bang just like me mopping with your eyes low. THC, gangster status, triple O. G with it and I ain't even trying to quit it. I'ma keep on smoking long as they say I can hit it. Now if they test me, I'ma probably piss a whole plant. These busters think they can outsmoke me, but they really can't. I've been a big reefer cheaper for a long time. Since the days I used to hang out on the block and grind. But now it's corporate business, oh yeah, I still hit it. This world is crazy and this chronic helped me deal with it. Shout out to those who voted yes on Prop 215 to legalize the green. You make me wanna say, nah, I'm just tripping with ya. That's how that chronic get ya. These pretty red, green, and purple buds, I need a swisher. Can do, but look, cause she's very old. I'm a 4-5% on Larry.
Song for you live.
Yeah,
I want
yeah.
You to really hear the message. Okay, look, it's a requirement to be on the show. You can't just come up on here. You gotta be.
Gotta work.
Activist.
I gotta work. I'm a smokedivist.
I don't care if you bring me $1,000. You gonna do?
I'm a smoking activist. So yeah, this is my song "Legalized." It was produced by Goldie Loca, the East Siders. A lot of people don't know that he also produces as well as, you know, being a part of the East Siders. I do come from Oklahoma City, which it ain't no way, shape, form, or fashion for legal weed going on out there. So that's one of the reasons I stayed in Cali. But I'm ready. Let's go. Drop it. It's called "Legalize," y'all. About one of my favorite things. Hey, what up? What up? The hip-hop show, hip-hop show. This is how we go. On that chronic smoke, everybody know we blow. Oh, yeah. It's legalized. It's already legalized. We don't need to do nothing else. The system really isn't broke. So why you want to fix it? Let's leave it like it is, you know? Hey, I'm on that bomb player, them California trees, them real sticky, icky, hydroponic, chronic leaves. It's only grown in water, it's what the doctor ordered, and I ain't even gotta get it from across the border. I'm smoking legal, I'm at the weed store, I go pick what I want, bag it up, pay and roll. Sativa for the day, indica for the night, 24-7, keep my body feeling right. I roll it up in my Zero Double XL. Don't want no other taste, don't want no other smell. And my license say that I can smoke all day. And if I got a little plot, I can cultivate. And keep a half a pound in my grip at all times. With an ounce off in my purse, oh yeah, I'm doing fine. Moving back to Oklahoma, last thing on my mind. I'm on the east side of Long Beach. Getting high into Bubba Kush Blueberry. Rolling down the 4-5, puffing on Mary. Granddaddy purple with the platinum OG. Chariot K-47 with no seams. LA Confidential, platinum blue dream. Purple God's gift, weed you never seen. Diablo Kush, Pineapple Express. We only smoking chronic, we don't want no stress.
By the time you wake and bake, boy, I done woke and smoke. Brush my teeth, cook some breakfast, and done choke some more. You bout four blunts behind, I got the fifth in line. Your lungs can't hang with mine, fool, I can smoke you blind. I don't think no girl can smoke as many blunts as me, except my girl from OKC, Sally Tammy T. We posted up on Florence, got seven blunts roll. It's only four people, oh yeah, we bout to blow. Abusive, Diamond and Skywalker, OG. Liquid, butter, private reserve, Louis 13. We top shelf cheap until somebody tap out. You say you what we smoke, or we gon' see what you about. It ain't no eye closing, it ain't no power napping. Inhale this chronic smoke, choke it out and let it happen. And put your hand up in the sky if you need some air. You said you wanted to get high, so we gon' take you there. Hindu, Bubba Kush, Blueberry. Rolling down the 4-5, puffin' on Mary. Granddaddy Purple with the Platinum OG. Cherry AK-47 with no seeds. L.A. Confidential, Platinum Blue Dream. Purple God Gift, weed you never seen. Diablo Kush, Pineapple Express. We only smoking chronic, we don't want no stress. Hey, I'm higher than the Cali Palm off that Cali Bomb. 420, that's my set, now let me court you on. So you can bang just like me, mobbing with your eyes low. THC, gangster status, triple O. G with it and I ain't even trying to quit it. I'ma keep on smoking long as they say I can hit it. Now if they test me, I'ma probably piss the whole plant. These busters think they cannot smoke me, but they really can't. I've been a big reefer cheaper for a long time. Since the days I used to hang out on the block and grind. But now it's corporate business. Oh yeah, I still hit it. This world is crazy and this chronic helped me deal with it. Shout out to those who voted yes on Prop 215 to legalize the green. You make me wanna sing. Nah, I'm just tripping with ya. That's how that chronic get ya. These pretty red, green, and purple buds, I need a swisher. Hindu, Bubba Kush, Blueberry. Rolling down the 4-5, puffing on Mary. Granddaddy Purple with the Platinum OG. Cherry AK-47 with no seam. LA Confidential, Platinum Blue Dream. Purple God's Gift, we just never seen. Diablo Kush, Pineapple Express. We only smoking chronic, we don't want no stress. Hindu, Bubba Kush, Blueberry. Rolling down the 4-5, puffing on Mary. Granddaddy Purple with the Platinum OG. Cherry AK-47 with no seam. LA Confidential, Platinum Blue Dream. Purple God's Gift, we never seen. Diablo Kush, Pineapple Express. We only smoking chronic, we don't want no strength. Yeah, no on AUMA. Natural Red in the building. The Hemp Hop Show with my boy Jimmy Diamond. Everybody in the house, hey, you let me hear some noise. My boy Roadkiller in the building. Yeah, Long Beach in the house. My hemp hop artist.
I'm talking about hemp hop. That's what hemp hop. Bringing it up to the pioneers of the Prop 215.
Yes. Thank you.
Yeah, man, you got down.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. So, yeah, man, you know, that song, I do music too, but, you know, what I want people to really understand, like I said, it's now it's corporate business, you know. When they turn this into a law, if you vote this into law, one of the things is you're going to have to get your rec. As when you go to renew as of January 1st, 2018, you can no longer get your rec from the regular doctor you've been going to. Your primary care physician is going to have to be the one that prescribes the marijuana to you. That's who you're going to have to get your rec from. That's one of the things that this law is going to do. That's one of the things that's hidden up under what they're trying to tell you. Right now, your employer can't bother you. It's just like being prescribed hydrocodone. But once they make this recreational, guess what? Your employer can now hassle you about it. It's no longer the freedom to use it as a medication if they decide to put it in policy that they don't want employees who use marijuana for medication. You can lose your job. Right now, you have a little bit of protection. But these are some of the things that's hidden in those pages that you want to make sure you vote against. I mean, they're trying to take you know, your freedom from you. This is crazy.
So they can make a place like a job. Let's say you work at a yard house, and they'd be like, "Oh, sorry, we don't hire people that use medical cannabis."
Absolutely. But it's going to be a discrimination, but it's going to be legal for them to.
Yeah, I was
going to
say that's almost like, you know, modern day racism. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Either way, yeah. Yeah. It's the same as saying, you know what, you take hydrocodone, we don't want you working for us.
Oh, you do this? Yeah, cool. That's
it's right. Also going to allow easier access to your medical records. Understand, you're going to be kept in a different database now. As of January 2018, they're going to be able to know what you do. It's not going to be protected by HIPAA as the rest of your medical records are, as the rest of your medical history is. This is something that they're going to be able to become aware of, whether you want them to or not.
They're going
to
know how much you actually consume. What kind of meds you can? Man, you know what? This is just a bottom line of violation of
invasion of privacy.
Was there any specific citations that you found in there after when you're reading around that really stood out to you? Like,
those were the ones I was just speaking on. I mean,
the track and trace system is what it's called. Chapter 17. Basically, they can violate all of our rules, all of our laws that protect us as patients right now.
Privileges.
At will. You know, and that's just it.
That's the thing we've been talking about. The privileges can be taken away. You don't need a warrant. That's the thing you were trying to talk about.
They've got that, and on top of that, the records keeping. There will actually be record keeping of your cannabis.
Track and trace.
And it's your track and trace. Really, and that's something right there that we need to be looking out
that's
for.
That's what I mean. Yeah.
Well, because they think you're a drug dealer. They have some cause. Yeah.
But just imagine going to your regular doctor.
They could just do it. Yeah. They could just do it.
You know what? I think
behind them comes the IRS, becomes the child services.
Yes.
Everybody comes with them.
The fact that we are building an entirely new Department of Government for regulation of something that the people have already voted yes on.
I don't know. I don't know what the OGs have against the DPA. I don't really know that whole story yet, but we'll have them in here at some point. But they're upset with them as much as the people are upset with Monsanto. So these people are riding this thing and involved with pushing it a little bit further. And I don't really want to say they're bad individuals in general. To be for this thing, you have to make some serious concessions on a whole bunch of other people. And the people you're siding with is going to be a person that has a big business and an attorney. Someone that's sitting in this room is not really the people in these functions where these people are putting this thing through.
It's pretty much making like your biggest fears, like as a patient, like, you know how, like, let's just, for example, like one of my, like if I go to like a cannabis event, I know it's like I'm protected. I got my law, you know, the laws on my side, you know, with my permit or whatnot. But like it almost like my biggest fear, like one of the fears is like I leave one of these events and my biggest fear is like there's a cop waiting outside waiting
they
to pull you over.
That.
And I feel like with this it's like this
more.
Is like giving them their permit to like, all right, cool. We know where the sesh is at. We have the right to post up and pull everybody over now. Or let's set up a DUI point real quick around here. That way we got a clear invitation to go into every person's car, see who has what, see who's smoking right now.
Really, at this point, they would just raid the event and just take everybody's stuff.
Right.
Pretty much.
That's how they do.
Pretty much this way, they would just raid the event and they would just take everybody's stuff. That's how much it gives them.
Well, with the provision they have in here.
This
about
is how much power this gives them.
Yeah. Right, but when this comes into act and they pull you over, then they're going to be able to decide on the spot.
But I tell you one thing though. There are some troubling provisions in here, but like, for example, the free sample thing.
This law is going to pay for them.
You know, I don't think that's enforceable.
Train.
I think if
because
the problem is no. I mean, eventually,
do you notice that the police get run off at the doors most of these events when we do deflect them and still keep the vent?
Yeah.
Okay, this is going to end that fucking. They're gonna mob up for them.
No, but my
like,
point is, my
kill
point
your dog.
Is,
well, how many dogs?
What's gonna happen is this is gonna be used.
We get to this. We got some video we're gonna play off real quick, and then we'll chime back in on some citations. So get some citations ready that you won't crack on. We got a clip from the Nest. Shout out to everybody on the Nest series, man. That shit is dope, and don't nobody know about it, huh?
Yeah, it's online. Rolling. It's the web.
All fucking bad.
What's up, man? What they say, dog?
What's up?
I don't know if he's gonna fucking make it, homes. Motherfucker got caught slipping, dog. We're gonna have to get to the bottom of this shit, homes.
What the fuck is this shit, man? How is Felipe? Is he okay? Is he gonna be okay, man?
Not looking good.
Man, I know what they're saying on the streets, babe, but I'm gonna tell you straight up, you know how far we go back, man. Eastside ain't have nothing to do with this shit, man. Nothing. Sister, and we ready to ride on whoever the fuck did this shit, man. That's
what,
my
mean, what the fuck? This is all bullshit.
Y'all missing, relax.
I love Felipe just like y'all
missing
my Felipe. We all go way back. Eastside and Aztec always been like, you gonna try to say that type of shit?
Get the homie, get the fucking money.
Really?
Come on,
man.
Yo, riding this. Sorry about that, mama. We'll talk to you later, okay?
All right,
relax,
right.
Man. What
fuck
the
that.
Fuck?
Let me stay at my home.
Fucking hospital.
Chili Rena, please come into the treatment area. Chili Rena.
What's up, nigga? That right?
Yeah, hey. That's done.
System motherfucking begin. System edition.
This we don't smoke the same. Nope. You basically put you to shame. What? With a tip in my joints that we smoking for real. We straight to the point, blowing smoke to your face. Blow. We don't smoke the same. Nope. You basically put you to shame. What? With a tip in my joints that we smoking for real. Fuck the police, blowing smoke to their face. I'm tired of being called a suspect. Cause that top shit that I smoke. Said we try and live free, but we get no respect. Nope. So I'd rather die faded than to die from a stroke. Yep. Several packs in the air, send them slap, blow by. Tips taking death till I die. Off the lips, drop the wrist, dab signs to the sky. Let's heat up that nail if you bout that light. Said we smoking right. Out of headies, off of which we got plenty. Plenty nails, stay ready. Smoke a killer, call it Kenny. Smoking cake life. Batter. And it's made by Crocker Betty. While you smoke, Greg, man, we really smoking heavy. I got trophy nugs with the trophy slabs. I got mighty plugs. Only COD cause we ain't starting tabs. And the shit we smoke is straight out the lab. We don't smoke the same. You basically put you to shame. With a tip in my joints that we smoking for real. We straight to the point, blowing smoke to your face. We don't smoke the same. You basically put you to shame. With a tip in my joints that we smoking for real. Fuck the police, blowing smoke to their face.
Many people like to brag and claim that we smoke a lot, but really we don't smoke the same. I'm smoking class A shit to put your garbage to shame. Fucking rookies taking dirty gas full of butane. No need to call out names, they know where they are. They like to smile in your face, but they hit from afar. Cause they wish they had the shit to put them down for the count. Smoking all day long, but they never surmount. My mind, I smoke one joint, sorry I lied. I smoke one joint, two, three, four, and five. Just enough to get me mentally stuck. They rate the refrigerator like a motherfucking fat fuck. You can trust nobody does it like us. And if you got a problem with it, you can suck on these nuts. Now watch me stun as I light up the Dutch in that 98 Corolla with my foot on the clutch.
We don't smoke the same. You basically put you to shame. With a tip in my joints that we smoking for real. We straight to the point, blowing smoke to your face. We don't smoke the same. You basically put you to shame. With a tip in my joints that we smoking for real. Fuck the police, blowing smoke to their face.
All right, that should go super hard. Nest Series, you gotta check it out at Nest Series on Instagram. You can find the whole thing on this on YouTube. All right, I wanna go around the room, let everybody know what your contact is and where your next thing is at. E-Zone.
All right, man. First of all, I want to go ahead and thank you guys over here at RMC, you know, for allowing me the opportunity to go ahead and give you guys my input, you know, as a patient and a host in this industry. You can find me at Be Real TV Monday through Friday on the Dr. Green Thumb Show, co-hosting along the doctor himself and a lot of my other co-hosts. Also, I might just be hosting an event coming near you. You know, I got the high-end sesh coming up. You can find me at your local sesh at anywhere around L.A. I'll be at mostly all of them. You know, I got love for everybody. That's why I roll the wine everywhere. But for the music, soundcloud.com/TheFirm. IG is Ezone, The Firm. And the Snapchat is Ezone Be Real TV. Everything else, you know, I'll be on Periscope a lot. It's like that inside look to my life. Ezone 89. The Periscope shit is live.
Thank you for being here.
Make sure you guys get informed. Thank you so much, Jimmy. Get informed, man. If you see this guy, just give him the fucking 5 minutes he deserves, all right? Because he's out there. He may not be the most animated motherfucker out there trying to convince you with a fucking firework and fucking roll out the red carpet for you, but he's fucking giving you the facts. You know what I mean? Because if it wasn't for him telling me, hey, this shit right here is going to take away your rights, or like, or it broke down to me, it's like, it was almost like I had to, it had to be dumbed down a little bit for a motherfucker like me to understand that. And I'm a college graduate. You know what I mean? But I'm also a consumer of cannabis. So you need people like Jimmy that are going to be out there fucking doing this shit just for the actual passion. You know what I mean? And getting you informed for doing this shit. Making you sign this, you know, making you sign the right papers. That way the industry, the cannabis community doesn't get Walmart. You know?
And volunteered for free, like a fuckload of hours and time and signatures.
Yes.
I will go in there and jack the empty ones of these so I can give them to the businesses I want to donate to CCHI so that nobody could turn them in. So I did my best to hit them on every end. Shout out to the Slump Wax family because they're the people that help us out with the paperwork side of this that nobody knows about. So stay informed on how shit works.
Yep, stay informed. That's the one thing I can say. It's been a pleasure being out here. I appreciate you guys.
If I could tell you what the next message is, that real short, the message I need you to preach to people is to register to vote.
Okay.
And to sign a petition that you read.
Use that power as an American.
I'm the one,
you know,
asshole,
what I mean?
Saying don't vote on the legalization thing. Do you know how weird that is?
But you're right though, man. People need to exercise their right to vote. Not a lot of people really do, and it's not. And you know,
it's
just
not just voting.
Yeah, though. It's not just voting. It's not just voting. It's getting
like
informed.
It's a sad state of affairs. That people probably know more about what happens in American Idol, who's gonna win, and people know their politician.
You got a
all that bread and circus.
I don't have any social media. I'm kind of under
the
radar.
You go from Secret Sesh. You can catch him live at Secret Sesh.
Catch me at the Secret Sesh.
Okay. This guy's a secret. So we can't tell you what.
Instagram at the Real Bernard Brand. That's it.
You finally made one. You can direct all hate to
at the Real Bernard Brand. Bring
man,
it on, baby.
Process it really quick and make them sign it, and you don't even know it. Shout out to the. What do you tell the people that give you a hard time for signing some shit with this? That they're so dumb.
Just go fuck yourself.
Convince them. let us know from your perspective what people need to do when somebody walks up with a grip of this junk that you don't want to see.
You look at the petition. If it's got staples in it, the more the pages, the more the bullshit. And Alma is the perfect example of that. You sit there and you look at something simple. If it's got three pages, look at the summary, see if it's something you want to vote on. If not, knock it out, leave it alone.
When they tell you, can you sign this one? And this one too. Fuck that. I walk away, man. Exactly. I'm like, I want one. Yep. Like,
JB?
Okay, social media, I guess. At JB_PopBags is my Instagram. It's my Twitter. I think it's my Periscope. It's pretty
1 minute.
Everything.
Tell me what you think of this AUMA thing.
I am one of the people who will sit down and go through the whole thing. So I am still going through, but I tell you, as a patient, it concerns me greatly. I don't like the fact that, as she were referencing before, it's now in the hands of my primary care physician. Suddenly, my neurologist, I have epilepsy, is now out of the mix on what I'm supposed to be taking.
What's your dynamics that you bring to your perspective of the shoes you're wearing?
I bring, an older perspective. You know, I'm not as young as the rest of them. As most of the people at the sessions, I like to talk to people. I come from back east. I come from New Hampshire. I'm a political family, so I'm more than happy to get into a political argument with you. If we disagree, that's great. If there's any message I can get off, is pay attention, be informed, make an informed decision. Just don't just go in and blindly check a box. You know, even if you disagree with everything we've had to say here.
And you know what? We can copy what they did to force
it,
CCHI on with
$4 million. just take the knowledge, yeah.
Red, what's up? What's with you?
Man, my next
gig is going to be the anniversary of, well, the Ruthless celebration for Eazy-E's birthday. That's coming up September the 10th. It's going to be hosted by my guy, Roach Killer, back here, my producer.
Hey.
You know, man, shout out to you guys for having me on, you for even giving this platform. Shout out to VIP Records, Long Beach.
Long Beach?
My social media is Instagram and Twitter at Natural Red Diva. Facebook is /Natural Red. Snapchat is The Natural Red. And what I got to say about this bill is don't be fooled. Do not be fooled. They're trying to make it seem like they're doing something for you, but they're not doing it for you. They're doing it for them. This is going to cause more people to be in jail. This is going to cause more people to lose their jobs. This is going to cause a lot of conflict in your life if you allow them to pass this bill.
Thank you, Ray. Which episodes are you in on Necessaries?
Can you know,
are you in all of them?
Watch all of them. Watch all of them. So you can understand.
It took me a minute to find the clip. Definitely want to watch.
Yeah.
So still, where you at?
At Stone Still on Instagram, on Facebook.
What's your projects that's most important to you?
Excuse me? Yes.
What's your projects most important to you right now?
Oh, this right now is the most important because without this, there's no us. There's no nothing. You know what I mean? It's really important. It really is that important, you know, to all the toughies in California, you know, patience.
You boy got something to say about that? Can't remember your name, sir.
Carlos.
Yeah, shout out to everybody supporting the Stone Still movie.
We had a dope-ass photo shoot.
Shout out to CHR, always supporting us, you know.
Shout out to my boy.
Shout out to, you know.
What's your opinion on this Prop 64 that you're understanding so far from your perspective?
I'm just getting all the info right now, you know what I mean? I'm not really up on it, but you know what I mean?
Okay, well, if this guy walks up to you with 15 stacks of paper like this, what do we got to do to take you from where you're at right now from this moment to a yes to what he's going to say but not to what somebody else is going to say? I need to decode that part because that's the only way I get my message farther.
I mean, it just all depends how he breaks it all down to me.
And then ask me if I know about it.
Be like, here, you need to sign this. It's going to help us in the long run. Can you sign it?
Okay.
I've had that. You know what I mean? I'm like, no, I'm not going
to
sign
it. How do you want to hear it?
You wanted to get simplified for you, right?
Yeah, you know, break it down to me. Like, let me know what's going to happen in the long run. Is it going to help us? Is it what's going to happen? You know,
as simple as they put it, you still got to see if they're telling you the truth or not. You know, you still have to see if they're telling you the truth or not.
You should be making.
You know, they're telling you it's marijuana legalization and it's not. You know what I mean?
So we have time
for your research. Important for everybody to
enlighten yourself.
Do their part. Get it out.
Like I said, biggest problem that happens right now is seriously too many people not paying attention. Stop watching.
The more pages, the more bullshit.
Yep. Yeah, that stuck to us earlier.
How much time we got to
you know, the Prop 215 was one paper.
It was one paper.
One sheet.
4 minutes.
One piece of paper.
One piece of paper.
Well, like I said, listen, you know, like I said, I have a weird perspective about all this because I used to be a probation officer back east, too.
Oh,
so I've seen...
How you put this out here?
I've literally seen both sides of this situation. I've seen it from the law enforcement side, and I've also seen it from the regular consumer side. I find it ironic that back east I was watching people for smoking weed, and then I came out here. Not only did I start smoking more weed than I ever smoked in my entire
life.
To me, the law enforcement side is making money off of it.
Let me ask you something as a PO, man. How many people, I mean, considering the fact that you smoke now, how many people that you're like, you know what, this was a good kid, like, I'm going to just let slide this one.
It didn't matter because he had to do his job.
I know people that got relationships with their POs.
This is a very good question. I always had people tell me this because I was one of the few probation officers that actually lived in the cities where people on probation, most people came from. So there's that disconnect. You know, you're not part of the community. You don't know this environment when you grew up in.
Yep.
So I get that all the time. And I used to sit there and see guys be like, man, this is bullshit. You know, we should be legal and this, that. And I would say, listen, man, we can have a moral and philosophical argument. I completely agree with you. I don't think we should be illegal. However,
the law is the law.
You got caught. You have to own up to your punishment. Now, I was never an unnecessarily unfair person.
It's not that you wanted to. It's just
it came with the job. And I always used to tell people straight, like, listen, we can have this argument, but the truth of the matter is, you got caught. Now you got a choice. You could play by the rules, get yourself off probation, and once you're off, smoke whatever the hell you want to smoke.
Once it becomes recreational, patients are going to have more problems like that.
But the laws don't change. So it's just a cycle.
But on another real thing, one of the things I will say about out here and about medical marijuana here in California,
how do we talk the cop out of the handcuff part?
You don't, dog.
You can't.
You don't.
Listen,
I tell you straight up, every day,
police officers,
I do the reverse
they do not think about your civil rights.
Well, they're the ones paying for AUMA.
They don't think about the Constitution. They do not care about you.
I want to thank everybody for being
Well, you
here.
Got a little fit. No, let them finish. This is important. This
is like 30 seconds.
They have a job. They have a job. They have a mission, and they have quotas.
And that's it.
And that's at the
so
end of the
I
day.
I know I changed the job description on that quota part. Yeah. Man,
voter registration. They're funding because they're going to get the money back
being
later.
Here. And you know what? I found a value in my haters. This show would not exist. I was here tripping out a minute ago. I was like, damn, this show really exists now. This show would not exist except for you assholes that didn't care. Because I had to figure out, okay, I'll figure out this. Nah, these cats just don't get it. So I figured out every angle that you got to work on that. You know, I don't have to deal with you no more.
They've been done
so
dry by
the government.
Thank
you for being at the show, everyone. Thank you for tolerating me.
Hey. Salute, brother.
Man, I got something for you to go out to. CCHI commercial. And that's gonna be the outro. We got Lyrics and Beyond. I forgot to plug where I'm at. I'm at Lyrics and Beyond, speaking for a half hour tomorrow. So free entry for whoever rolls with me. You know what I'm saying? Give me a ride. That's what I mean. Call in. Let's keep it real. We all know how this shit works. Okay. So look, I really need people, so I don't have to pay with GR. So it's a little bit of money for this episode. So if you could hit the donation bucket in the bio thingy.
$5, $1.
We can do shout outs. We'll figure it out. You know, I try to break it down where everybody can participate. So, deuces, thank you for the hip hop show.
Thank you.
Thank you to Jesus.
Empirically, but typically, you wouldn't open up your third eye to learn it spiritually and mentally.